Hey, my name is Per Mars. I'm the founder and inventor of Marsblade and flow motion technology. And I have some really exciting news to share with you today. Since the start of Marsblade in 2011, we've seen and felt the benefits of a rocking chassis and a dynamic pitch for both off-ice training and on-ice performance. And we've always been eager to learn more about how the technology in our blade holders affects your performance on the ice. We've done several tests in the past, both internal ones and external ones, and they have all shown great results, indicating that flow motion technology, in fact, will improve your performance on the ice. This time, we wanted to take a more scientific approach and validate the technology's benefits through an independent third party. So we decided to work with Brock University and George Brown College in Canada, some of the leaders in the world of hockey science. To understand the framework of the study, it helps to understand the concept of pitch angles, the angle between the foot and the ice. The Marsblade i2s have a dynamic pitch, providing you with a range of pitch angles through a rocking motion between the holder and the steel. In contrast, a traditional holder only has one fixed pitch angle.
The study consisted of three phases, one theoretical and two physical. In the first phase, mathematical calculations and simulations were done to analyze how the different pitch conditions affected the interaction between the steel and the ice. Phase two consisted of treadmill skating in a controlled lab environment, where three different skills were tested: forward skating, backward skating, and C-cuts. Two identical pairs of boots were equipped with holders permitting two different pitch conditions, one dynamic and one fixed. The profile and hollow were kept identical between the two sets of skates, and a 20 feet radius insert was used in the Marsblade i2s. The participants were 11 male high-level collegiate hockey players, none of which had previous experience with the Marsblade i2s, but all of them had adequate treadmill skating experience and were granted a 2-hour familiarization period on the Marsblade holders prior to testing. The treadmill was set at a constant speed, and the participants were simply tasked with maintaining that speed. And at the same time, kinetic data was captured using pressure-sensitive insoles, measuring how much force the skater needed to apply to maintain the set speed. And kinematic data was captured using 17 motion capture sensors placed on the athlete's bodies. The on-ice test consisted of three isolated drills for forward skating, backward skating, and C-cuts, as well as two longer drills to simulate more game-like skating, a saber course and a diagonal course.
Looking at the results, we could see a clear pattern. The players used less force on the i2s compared to rigid holders in all tested scenarios. For forward skating, the players used, on average, 5.85% less force on the i2s. For backward skating, 4.84%, and for C-cuts, 7.38%. These results are from the treadmill testing, as it provided the most accurate and isolated measurements for each respective skill. The results on ice showed even more significant improvements, but were not as isolated, so we decided to focus on the more frugal treadmill results until more on-ice testing has been conducted. In our eyes, these results are very impressive, and especially given the fact that the players didn't get more than 2 hours on the Marsblade holders before testing, and in my world that's extremely short. Both players and coaches at the very highest level already confirms to us that the technology is superior. To us this is huge, but it's of course only based on their personal experience. And that's why all of us at Marsblade are very proud of the fact that our technology is now backed by science.